Action, let's see, where are we? We're 15, item 15. Action is necessary or appropriate on matters discussed in executive session. I think we need a vote on A, executive session A. Do I have a motion, Mr. Lovelace?
I make the motion that we approve the selected employment items, exhibit A for action.
Mm-hmm. Is there a second? Thank you, Ms. Gardner. Any discussion? Yes.
Ms. Hammond, under policy BBBC, I'm submitting a letter to you with my resignation from the board. And I do not agree with item 3D and the settlement agreement that this board participated in with Dr. Melton. And I'm leaving the meeting. I'm not going to participate in this board any further. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have something to comment.
Is there, well, let's get, we have the motion of selected employment items A.
Yeah, that,
and I thought his statement had to do with that, and it didn't. So, is there a second?
Second.
Well, it is about employment items.
I second it. That's not on that item. All right.
She seconded.
You second it. Okay. All those in favor of select employment items as seen in Exhibit A.
I want to discuss that for a minute, if you could.
The vote?
No, that item. I just wanted to say, just make a comment. It's not a question. It's just a comment. Okay. I noticed in the paper this morning there was an article in there about that said that this district had 125 employees that it was or teachers that it was short. After this vote, that will, if successful, after this vote, the number of teachers that we will be short is somewhere in the range of 57. So I wanted to clarify that because it was very unfair to the school district for a reporter to report that in the state paper. So I just wanted to make sure that we all understood that the situation is not as dire as what was reported. It's not dire at all, and that we do have sufficient interest in our school district. So I just wanted to make that statement, and I wanted everybody to, you know, out there to understand not to believe everything you read in the state paper.
Okay. Well, let's take a vote on selected employment items, Exhibit A. It's in favor. 1, 2. And we have 6. And there were no other votes to be taken from executive session. Town of Chapin easement request is seen in action. I mean, number 16, Exhibit C.
Ms. Hammond, Mr. Beedenbow has made his way to the podium as our Executive Director of Operations. He, of course, has sent to the board some things to preview and has updated the officers, and tonight he's here to offer some comments and then accept questions. Mr.
Okay.
Beedenbow.
Thank you, Mr. Beedenbow.
Thank you, Chair Hammond, board members, Dr. Melton. This is a request from the town of Chapin. This is a sidewalk easement request that's 10 feet in width, and it's from in front of the old Chapin High School, and this goes from the new town of Chapin to Columbia Avenue. And again, it's a pedestrian sidewalk that is parallel to the existing right-of-way on Northwest Columbia Avenue between the Chapin Branch Library and the town of Chapin property, the current town hall of Chapin.
Thank you. Any board member questions? Ms. Huddle.
I was just curious. It's 10 feet wide, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
That seems a little wide for a standard sidewalk, so I was just curious if there was a reason.
By the time they get the utilities and everything, I think they'll need 10 feet to construct a sidewalk and for utilities.
Okay, yes, so the sidewalk itself may not be 10 feet. They
yes,
just
ma'am.
Need 10 feet.
Yes,
gotcha.
Ma'am.
And correct me if I'm wrong, there's no sidewalk on the other side of the road, right? Because
that's correct.
The train.
That's right.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks.
Any other questions on the easement? And I think we need action on that. Am I correct, Ms. Beedenbow?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do I have a motion? Ms. Huddle.
I move that we approve the easement request for the town of Chapin in the area adjacent to the property from the old high school. Is that good enough?
Okay. And I have a second from Ms. Hines. Any questions? All those in favor of the easement? 6-0. Okay, item 17, second reading approval of the 2022 general fund budget as is seen in Exhibit D and already been presented by Ms. Rawls.
Ms. Hammond, I'll ask Ms. Rawls to come back to the podium. We'll be prepared to answer questions from Exhibit D. The presentation is from earlier, should there be any slides that the board would like to have Ms. Rawls to review, we can certainly pull that slideshow back up to the appropriate slide.
Okay, I think she's done a good job, but there still might be some questions. You want to just start it with any questions rather than since we already had the presentation? Now, Ms. Huddle had her question.
I'm pretty sure in the slides on the details, we had stipends for middle and high schools, and we did add stipends for team leads for elementary schools.
Yes, ma'am.
Great, thank you.
Mr. Lovis, you had a question?
Yeah, one comment I wanted to make. I've got three things I want to say, but one of the comments appreciate you putting that information for the social workers.
Yes, sir.
And I, you know, after having visited some of the schools and so forth, I mean, I really think that those guys do a great job. And they, you know, with as little resources as we give, and I want to commend you for thinking of them, and I want to ask this board to also let's look at giving them more resources in the form of pay for these social workers, because I think having heard some of what we heard tonight, I think, you know, that to me is justified, and really, I don't see how the schools operate without them. I'm gonna be honest with you. So,
there again, I'm just a spokesperson. That is definitely an executive staff priority. Dr. Harris has, and I have had many conversations about the need for it. So I don't take credit for it being in the budget. It's definitely a priority of the district.
Well, thank you guys again. I'm Dr. Harris. All of you guys for considering them. I think that was really important. I've got some other questions.
I'm satisfied with the budget, but I need to see what anybody else. I want to take turns with everybody. Let me see, since you had one. Ms. Hines, any question? Mr. Hogan, Ms. Gardner? Okay, so I'll go back to, and I'll come back to you.
Okay. Last one, I promise. I actually meant to go back to the Piney Woods. So I think you said there was a $2 million, I can't remember what that was called, but where did that come from and what is it being used for?
There was a board assignment for that out of fund balance last year. I think it happened at the October meeting, if I'm not mistaken. So it was $2 million assigned to the startup funds. So for instance, some security measures have been paid out of that. And Mr. Biedenboe, you may be able to answer that more specifically than I can, because I think a lot of it happened before I got here, but library books.
Okay, but it's not being paid to the construction.
No, ma'am. Gotcha. No, ma'am. Okay. It is all school supplies and resources needed to start the school.
Okay, thanks.
I think there's some custodial equipment, as a matter of fact, with some things purchased with it.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, and is that yours, Ms. Huddle? Mr. Lovis, you had one more?
Yeah, two more. First of all, on your memorandum, and recommendation number two was 75.4 mils for debt service. And I noticed on one of those slides it was 73 mils.
It's not necessarily going to be 75.4. That is where we are now. That rate will be calculated once we have the debt, like Ms. Murphy talked about, the debt service reserve fund. And know what our obligations are. So that is probably going to be closer to 73 mils, but it will not be higher than 75.4 mils.
Okay. Do you remember the meeting I think it's your second meeting, and we talked about the board saved 2.3 mils by not increasing millage?
Yes, sir.
Is that included in the 75?
That would be representative by that 73 mils. That would be based on the savings from not issuing the 11.17 million in the capital reserve.
Okay, so if we approve this would include the two, whatever we didn't approve back in at the prior board meeting?
It will be calculated based on the requirements. So because we only issued 10 million in bonds, that would be part of that calculation, yes.
Okay. The second thing that I wanted to ask you, because you said something that I don't think I've ever heard before, but it was talking about unassigned fund balance.
Right.
Okay. this is what, just rough crude numbers, but I took 201,694,166, okay? And I took 18% of that, which is the top rate, the top of the rate that we could use for fund balance. And that came out to $7,361,837. Okay, so we are over. In other words, right now, if you took the percentage that you showed us, which was $43,675,282, wasn't that it? That was roughly it, wasn't it?
We're going to be about $43,600,000, yes, sir.
Okay, so that's 21.65% if you divide that by 201 million, okay? So we are over the top limit by 3.65%, if I've calculated right, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that means that the fund balance would grow by $7,361,000 with that overage, mm-hmm. right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what are we doing? We're going to have to return that to the taxpayers or spend it on something, or what are we going to do with that?
No, sir. You all, as the board, have the opportunity to make assignments like we have in the past years, either through for capital reserve projects. I know that was a question that you had, Ms. Huddle. There was a $2 million assignment 2 years ago for a capital reserve. Dr. Melton, I know there have been employee appreciation bonuses right. paid out of that as well. So I think there are options. I can tell you, from a financial standpoint, it would be better for our bond rating. Right. It would be better for us not to use that for balancing the budget, using the operational fund balance to do that, because that's viewed negatively when they look at our bond ratings. Right. So it would be better for the board to determine assignments for specific purposes for that overage.
Okay, well, last week we had the facilities committee, and in the facilities committee, we talked about uses of funds. And some of those uses of funds had to do with the MBCON report. And we had in there information that was necessarily there because there were security items that we needed to do to make our buildings secure. Okay, and the reason we had the facilities committee meeting was to discover what we could do with some of these excess funds that we have here. And so I just wanted to clear that up, because we've had a lot of miscommunication, I'll put it that way, about the need for our committees. And so that was one thing that we discussed in there, if you will remember.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. That answers my comments and questions.
I actually have a follow-up question now, sorry. So if we end up with a greater fund balance, we could take that money. Would the board need to make a vote to take that money to put more security at certain schools, or, you know, more maintenance, that kind of thing? Is that a possibility, or are we not allowed to use operating funds for that?
Ms. Huddle, Ms. Hammond, if I may insert here, as a staff, we've been looking through the lens of all available funds, and of course, we were not anticipating the ESSER III funds, but since those funds are available, it would be our recommendation to look at all available funds to see what projects can be accelerated, what goals of the board may suggest. If there is the will of the board for other items, then of course the administration could work to have that. I'm hesitant and protective of Ms. Rawls, because of course her preparation for this evening is based upon the presentation you've seen to include her recommendations, and although she has a computerized memory, it's 9 o'clock in the evening, and I'm hesitant to ask her to think too much on her feet without. So, Ms. Rawls, maybe we could collect some of the questions that are being asked, and then we could follow up in writing, or either in the next presentation if there is the one that's warranted. But Ms. Huddle, it'd be very appropriate for the board to take action in the future to review anything that may be changed using all available funds to make sure that the objectives are being met.
And this goes in line with the mid-year review and amendment that we discussed during the presentation. So, yes, ma'am.
So I think to put us back to where we are, we would have a vote on the second reading of the general fund budget as she proposed. Ms. Hines.
I'd like to make a motion to approve the second reading for the adoption of the fiscal year 2021-2022 general fund budget as presented, including the continuation of the remaining fund balance assignment for Piney Woods Elementary School in 2021 and 2022.
Is there a second? Mrs. Gardner seconds. Any questions on that? All those in favor, raise your hand. And there are six and no opposed. And gosh, it's a
hold
great.
On, Ms. Hammond.
Hold on, there's another.
What did I leave off?
There's another recommendation.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you had two in that one. Yep. Yeah, sorry. Okay.
It's okay. I'd like to make a motion to approve setting the operating millage rate at 246.10 mils and the debt service millage rate at a calculated rate to meet the debt service obligations not to exceed the current rate of 75.4 mils.
Is there a second? Mr. Hogan seconds. Okay. And since you made that, you can speak to it.
But it's a recommendation. I'm okay. Just voting on the recommendation.
All right. No more questions. Although
on discussion, though, yeah. I'm glad that we have a mid-year review. It sounds like this is the right course of action. We won't be increasing taxes. We did get a little slight decrease on the capital budget. So what we're saying is the tax rate's going to stay the same. And we might end up with a little cushion, but the way I understand it, we can reassign that cushion as needed. We've got this MBCon and other studies that show we need to do some more with maintenance. So normally I would say don't take more than you need, but I think we need it. So I would just make that point before we vote.
Okay, thank you. Any other comments? All those in favor of Ms. Hines? And that is six.
Ms. Hammond?
Yes.
I would like to make a motion to return to executive session to receive legal advice regarding a contractual matter.
Okay, is there a second? Ms. Gardner, seconds. All those in favor of returning? I may not can return. Okay, that was, how many? I didn't get all the count. One, two, three, four, five. Two, one, no. Okay. So, I will adjourn this meeting, and we will adjourn to executive session, although